Hi friends, I'm Brigadier Vijay Sagar Dhiman. I'm back here again being with you. And now I shall be talking to you something about the management that happens in every sphere of life. Well, in this series called Learn Management from the Army, I shall be telling you how can you achieve your objectives in any organization, whether it is social, political, business, or even a family. A family unit is also an organization. How the management principles are used to get a better objectives, better results in your life. I must remind you here, all the management principles that are being taught in the business schools all over the world, let me tell you, all these principles originated from the army right from First World War. And today we are an organization which is a well-oiled organization. It has a well-oiled system of training. So I'll tell you what are the lessons that we draw out every day. Like in any organization, you need to have a mission. Then thereafter, you need to build a team. Then you have to train the team. And then you have to do the operations to get that goal. So guys, armed forces also similar organization, which has a goal. And goal, as I told you, the mission that we have is to defend our borders against external threat. Also, to defend our country against internal problems. It could be insurgencies, it could be normal armed revolts, etc., etc. Now, to get this particular mission, we have to build a team. And then we have to train the team. And then we have to do the operations. Now, how to build a team? We have certain segments in the armed forces. We have people at the Jawans level. We have people at the JCOs level. Then we have officers. Jawans and officers are recruited and JCOs get promoted after they have put in certain number of years of service as a Jawan. So this is the basic organization which is recruited. Thereafter, their training starts in different various institutions that we have in the army. Each department of the army, this could be fighting arms like your foot soldiers or tankmen. It could be supporting arms like artillery with guns, engineers with the combat support, signals with communications and air defense, etc. And then we have certain services. We have ordnance services, we have supply services, we have electrical and mechanical core services, and we have medical services. Now these people are trained into their respective centers, and officers are trained in institutions like National Defense Academy, Indian Military Academy, OTA, and in other naval academies and the Air Force academies. So after they are basically trained from there, they are sent to the units. Units, we have smaller units called sections. Sections then converted, three sections joined together to make a platoons. Then we have companies, then we have units. And then we have brigades and divisions and corps, etc. So likewise, this is the basic structure of the army in which the teams are built. So teams are recruited after basic training, they come to the unit. Then unit has a certain mission which is assigned to it. And to achieve that, they start training. Now how do they do it? Now this all happens with the help of a credo that is given to us. It's called Chetwode Motto. There was a commandant of Indian Military Academy at one point in time, General Philip Chetwode, and he gave a motto. And today I will tell you about that motto. The motto is safety, honor, and welfare of your country comes first, always, and every time. That is the mission that we have to achieve. That is to defend the external borders and do internal security. That is always first and always and every time. And second was, then it says, the honor, welfare, and comfort of your men, that is your team, comes next. And then it says, your own ease and comfort is last, always and every time. So this is the mission given to the officers. Now we will see how do we achieve the first one, that is safety, honor and welfare of your country comes first, always and every time. Okay, as I said, the mission is to defend the country from external and internal threats. Now how do we do it? We try to teach this to the men as well as the officers who form a team. Now this team is indoctrinated into this particular thing in a very, very consistent and a very concerted manner. There are certain wartime missions which are told, and there are certain peacetime missions. They all told, rehearsed, taught, and they are even practiced as well as they are tested. Thereafter, we have a system of telling the traditions of the unit. The history of the unit is told. Like most of the units have been in the war during First World War and thereafter, and some even before that. So all those stories are told to the people and told them what the history of this regiment or history of this unit is, so that they get motivated and they're told to maintain this. They should not be unit ki naam pe kahin pe daag dhabba nahi lagna chahiye. Naam, namak, nishan. These are the three things which are very, very important for any team, that is any unit. Thereafter, we have certain battle presentations which are enacted. We have certain stories of valor which are told to people. Then we have citations written to a system to give awards to people who do well in say a certain amount of war situations during peacetime, or maybe line of control, which is an actual war situation, or line of actual control, or even actual ground position line, that is CHN place. And then they are also told the stories about our awardees, Paramveer Chakra, gallantry awardees, Paramveer Chakra, Mahavir Chakra. Like I can name a few, like Major Somnath, because of whose valor and he laid down his life to make sure that that J&K does not fall in the hands of those raiders in 1947. Like stories of valor of Major Shaitan Singh, who with handful of men almost stopped the entire Chinese formations, and in the bargain they all laid down their own lives. Like CQMH Abdul Hamid, who during in 65 war single-handed with one recoilless gun, not even a tank, he almost destroyed so many patent tanks, Pakistani patent tanks, which were considered invincible at that time. Like our Vikram Batra, Paramveer Chakra in Kargil, I can show you the kind of places that they captured, the kind of cliffs that they climbed up. It is humanly impossible to do that, but they did it just because their mission was absolutely clear to them. They had no doubts what mission was to be given to them. So these kind of stories, when they're told to the teams, that is the units, they get motivated, they get excited, and then it gets ingrained into their minds. Okay, look, naam, namak, nishan of the unit should not go bad. We have been given a particular mission, we have to count to get it. So this is a particular lesson that the army first teaches you, the armed forces teach you, that you should always try to make sure that your mission is 100% accomplished. There are no runners up in war. War is only for the winners. So guys, this is the in this series of very many videos, I'll tell you many lessons that army teaches you in management. You can use this at home, you can use in your personal lives, you can use in your office, you can use in your corporates, and wherever you feel, all these lessons will come handy. And there are a lot of misconceptions that you may have, I'll try and clear them. So bye for now and see you again.
Give me some sunshine, give me some rain, give me another chance, I wanna grow up once again. Give me some sunshine, give me some rain, give me another chance, I wanna grow up once again.
कंधों को किताबों के बोझ ने झुकाया, रिश्वत देना तो खुद पापा ने सिखाया. 99% मार्क्स लाओगे तो घड़ी पाओगे, वरना छड़ी. लिख लिख के पढ़ा हथेली पर अल्फा बीटा गामा का छाला. कंसंट्रेटेड H2SO4 ने पूरा पूरा बचपन जला डाला. बचपन तो गया, जवानी भी गई, एक पल तो अब हमें जीने दो, जीने दो. बचपन तो गया, जवानी भी गई, एक पल तो अब हमें जीने दो, जीने दो.
जो चला गया यार, उसे तो हम नहीं बदल सकते, बट जो आज और आने वाला कल है उसे हम जरूर चेंज करेंगे। इसीलिए कहते हैं वी कांट चेंज अ पास्ट बट वी कैन चेंज अ फ्यूचर विद अ न्यू करेक्टेड बिगिनिंग। तो आइए करते हैं एक नई शुरुआत एक नए तरीके से। सो गाइज लेट्स बी द चेंज एंड टेक गाइडेंस फ्रॉम मी फॉर योर प्रेशियस करियर्स एंड फ्यूचर। After more than 38 years in the armed forces and serving the nation, now I am here to serve the youth of my country by imparting the instructions in career counseling, consultancy in this your careers and confidence measures, etc. Now this is because of my accreditation from International Coaching Federation, United States of America as a life skills facilitator. So friends, visit me today at brigadierguideyou.com and all other social media platforms. Looking forward to interact with you, waiting to hear from you. Goodbye and Jai Hind.